Hey guys, so a week ago I hit 1,000 subscribers, so thank you very, very much for everyone that subscribed, everyone that likes or comments or watches these videos. There's a few of you that comment on every video and it's always really thoughtful and I appreciate it very much. I know exactly who you are. So cheers to 1,000 subscribers. I decided to have an afternoon beer. 805 by Firestone Walker Brewery. I don't want to make the Donald Trump mistake. Okay, so I'm making this video because since I just hit 1,000, I thought it would be a really good time to sort of give you my walk away story, because I'm still technically registered as a Democrat. Now that will be changing, but I've been a Democrat my whole life. I switched right after the election, right after 2016. There's a saying, if you're young and not a liberal, you have no heart. If you're older and not a conservative, you have no mind. And that's basically exactly what happened to me. I grew up under sort of the same ideas as everyone else. I always thought Fox News was evil. It was the old white man in the suit. That's what I thought of as Republicans. I thought of Republicans as out of touch, and they don't want the best, and they're the capitalists and the corporations and this and that, and they didn't care about the little person. And I always thought of the Democratic Party as the party that cares about the poor people and or underprivileged and minorities. I just thought that was the party of good. That was the party of charity. And obviously, you want to be a good and charitable person. So that's the party you go with. And that's just always what I thought. So my first election, I voted for John Kerry. The second one, I voted for Obama. And at this point, I started getting a lot more into politics. My friend and I would go hang out at the Democratic headquarters, and we would get Obama signs and we would put them up in our yards, and the evil Republicans would tear them back down, and we would take them and we would put them back up. Evil Republicans would take them down, and this would happen all the time. I would go out and try to get people to vote. I would encourage them to vote. I made sure my parents voted. I was super into the elections. I think the first time that Obama won, celebrating, my friend and I got wasted on Obama teenies. I think she had blue throw up somewhere. But I was just super liberal, super Democratic. And so this happened, and simultaneously, like at Obama's first term is when I started going into the workforce. And just like a true liberal, I studied human services, and I immediately started going into sort of the social work field. But I worked in a psychiatric hospital. It was a state-run psychiatric, acute care psychiatric hospital for children and adolescents. So I worked there for a few years. I worked for the city of Denver for a few years at a place called the Family Crisis Center. I worked with a lot of people on welfare. We worked in the projects. We helped kids that were abused and neglected by their parents, or kids that were just getting into a lot of trouble and not going to school. So during my time working for these places, I started to learn a lot of real life things. I started to learn that the welfare state keeps people down. I remember one time I was monitoring two 13-year-olds, and they were just chit-chatting. I just happened to be around and catch some of their conversation. And both really bright girls, like smart, like good heads on their shoulders, like have all the potential in the world. And I remember one of the girls looking at the other one, and they're getting ready and they're just having normal teenage girl chit chat. And she goes, yeah, when we're older and we get our checks, you know, we should be roommates and this and that. And I was thinking about that, and it's just an innocent thing that they said, but that was just a little bit of a window in the mindset of a lot of people that lived in this area. These kids, as much as we worked with them and as much as we told them that they were smart and tried to give them resources, they go back into that. They just assume that they are gonna grow up and just be on welfare like their parents. And they just, they take that and they assume it, and that's how they lived their life. That was a large number of the people that I worked with. So it was things like that. I also dealt with illegal immigration and the effects on that. We had a kid at one point who lied about his age. He told us he was under 18. He in fact was not. We didn't have papers on him, but because we were a government facility, we had to take him in. We were a residential facility, so it was an overnight facility. He was being housed with underage girls and underage boys, and as we had him, the more and more we had him, we started getting papers on him, realized he was in fact over 18, and he was wanted in Mexico for a murder charge, but we didn't know those things because we didn't have papers on him due to the fact that he was here illegally. If we would have had that information, we would not have placed him, and it actually, he ended up getting arrested in our facility because it became that unsafe. He started a riot, completely destroyed property, his room, and was violent towards staff and other kids. So those are just two examples. I could go on for days and days and days, but I won't bore you with that. But even still, I'm learning these things. I'm seeing these things real life, but still my politics are Democratic, if you were to ask me that. I never made the connection. Again, I never questioned. I never looked into it. I just assumed that Democrats were the party of the good. So what happened? It was really Obama's second term where things just started not feeling right. I felt like he talked a lot. He sounded good. He was charismatic. You know, we all, how could you not like Obama? And I just felt like, you know, all these things were happening. We had a bunch of shootings. We had a few other things happen. And I believe his campaign was, I can't remember the exact slogan, but it always had to do with change. He was going to bring change and he was going to bring hope. And him getting into office meant a lot to a lot of people. And, you know, he had the first 4 years. Okay, not a lot happened. Second 4 years. And then I just saw nothing happening. I continued to see him go on TV and be charismatic and say all the right things, but nothing was happening. Nothing changed. The only thing that I saw change was Obamacare, and I thought that that was a disaster. I just saw my parents who were poor get penalized because they couldn't afford insurance and they got laid off from their jobs because of the financial crisis. That's the biggest impact I saw of Obama's presidency, and maybe that's personal, but you know. So I just sort of lost my faith in politics. I was always big on voting. I was always big on you have to go out and vote. And in 2016, at that point, I had moved to Hollywood. I got an acting agent. I was auditioning a lot. I was really busy. And I just, or that was 2015, I'm sorry. And I just wasn't really paying attention to the election as much. And it was because I just lost my faith in politics. I thought, you know, it doesn't matter who you put in office. Nothing is ever going to change. Nothing's ever going to be different. So the debates are happening. Everyone's campaigning, this and that. And I just didn't pay attention to it that much. I would turn on and watch a few minutes of the debates here and there, or watch some clips from CNN or this and that. And I was sort of up to date on the news, but not super involved in it. And I remember just thinking like, wow, Donald Trump is a clown. Like, how can anyone vote for this guy? I thought there was no way he was going to be elected into office. And I thought, and if I voted, I would have voted for Hillary. So fast forward a few days before the election. Again, I didn't have any personal feelings. I just thought Hillary had it in the bag. There's no way Donald Trump's getting elected. He's just a silly man. He doesn't know anything. He sounds silly. I would just watch clips from him from CNN, and they, of course, make him look like a clown. So that was my thinking. I fly to Virginia. My mom picks me up from the airport. We're driving around, and all of a sudden, I start seeing Trump signs everywhere. And I was like, people are voting for Trump? You have to understand, I'm coming from Hollywood, where it's just super liberal. And I see Trump signs everywhere. And to me, it's like seeing a unicorn. And my mom was like, yeah, you know, people are voting for him. And this is why. My mom explained that she was voting for him. And I was like, whoa. And again, it wasn't personal. I didn't get mad. I was just, it was fascinating to me. So we have this conversation, and I'm still my liberal self. And what happened the next day was it really, really, really broke my heart. And it's what really opened my eyes. The next day, I went out to lunch with my mom and another family member. And this is a family member I hadn't seen in a long time. I live far away. I think I hadn't been home in like almost a year. This was the first time like we were kind of all together, and it was going to be fun and chit chat, and we were going to have lunch. Silly me didn't know how real politics got. So I brought up the election, which at this point, it was either that day or the next day. And I was like, hey, he's trying to bring up conversation. I was like, hey, are you going to vote or this and that? And silly me, silly, silly, stupid me brought up that my mom was voting for Trump. And I thought I was being silly. I thought I was being cute. I thought I was safe among family. We all know each other. We all love each other. I had no idea how deranged people had got, it turned into an all-out brawl to the point where I ended up sitting at the table by myself. And I remember talking to my mom later that night, and she goes, you know what, Sarah, I grew up poor. I grew up, and she did. My mom grew up living in the project. She was always poor. She had a really dark childhood, and a lot of things happened in her childhood. And she's like, I'm a good person, and I want good things. And I started listening to her, because the fact that you can get that mad at a family member and at a good family member that quickly, that just showed me something is seriously wrong here. If you're emotional about your politics, it's one thing to talk about your politics and get passionate or to get a little angry or this and that. But when it's so emotional, when it has control over you to the point where you are fighting with your family, that is just, it really got to me. And I wanted to figure out what was going on here. And it gets a little worse. So, you know, I'm watching the election with my mom and my stepdad. That night, we're drinking beers, we're watching it, and we're all shocked just like everyone else is every time Trump gets a state. I believe I was on the East call, so the election wasn't called until 4 a.m. So I'm like texting one of my friends back and forth. We're texting, it's my best friend I've known my whole life. What's going on in the election? Who's gonna have it? Who's gonna have it? And finally, they called Trump at 4 a.m. and her and I were going back and forth. They call Trump and I immediately see Facebook, Twitter, everything explodes and people lose their freaking minds. And I thought Trump was a clown too, but I mean, come on, people. So I text my friend, who I'm thinking we're on the same page, we're both same people, right? So I text my friend and I was like, wow, people are really freaking out about this election. That's crazy. And I get this just paragraphs back in a text message. People are just expressing their feelings and they're allowed to do that. And it was like Trump is a Nazi dictator and there was like white supremacy and the patriarchy and evil. And I was like, what has become of this world? When I left politics, when I left friendly debates, when I told you I voted Democrat, I had friends, my really good friend and I were both very liberal, and her boyfriend at the time was actually in college studying poli sci, and he was a staunch Republican. We used to have beers and get into debates, and no one ever got their feelings hurt. Her and I never got our feelings hurt. What happened to that? So this what happened mentally to a lot of people really fascinated me, because that's not okay. Anytime something grabs at your emotions like that, especially politics, it's just not okay. It's not healthy. Something's going on there. So what happened was I listened to my mom and she had really good arguments as to why she was voting Republican. And also at the time there was, Hillary was pretty corrupt. So a lot of her voting for Trump had to do with the fact that Hillary was so corrupt as well, which I wasn't even aware of, but now I know a little bit more about. So I wanted to figure out what was going on with people and how we got to this place. And I started doing research. Like I was up till maybe 4 or 5 in the morning, night after night after night, just doing research and studying things and this and that. And I realized that Republicans are the party of freedom of speech and for the right to protect yourself and for a small government and personal responsibility and you can do it and border control and safety. And why are any of these things bad? And so I'm starting to listen to Republican speakers like Ben Shapiro. Who else was I listening to at the time? My head is going blank, I apologize. But Ben Shapiro was one of my first ones. And then listening to him and simultaneously hearing what people are saying about him, I tried so hard to find anything racist that he had ever said or anything bigoted that he had ever said, and I couldn't. And you can argue that you don't like his opinion and that it's wrong, but to just label someone and attack their character just because you don't like their argument is not okay. And like I said, before anything, I am a defender of the truth. And I always am on the side of the truth. And I don't see truth on the Democratic side. I found out that it was a lot of lies that I had been fed my entire life thinking that they care. And what I noticed too, on the Republican side, everyone is so nice. Everyone is so accepting. Everyone is so open. It's the Democratic side. That's the side of the hate. That is the side of the anger. That is the side of the bullies. Just look at it. Look at the names that Republican speakers get called. Especially Black Republican speakers. Look at the names that they get called. And then look at how Republicans criticize. You can't even, it's completely different. And so that's why I started seeing through the lies. I started, when I did my own research, I saw how networks like CNN and NBC would twist the truth just to push their narrative. And yes, Fox News is guilty as well, but CNN is basically is the biggest offender of that, hands down. And since I have changed my mind on a lot of things, a lot has become pretty clear to me. I hope that made sense. It was a little rambly. I've tried to get it all out. There's definitely other things that have happened along the way. And I've already gotten backlash from my family just for like little things that I might post on my social media, or if they see I worked on a conservative sketch comedy show and now I make these videos. So I've definitely got in the past week a lot of backlash, and it's really sad and it breaks my heart. But at the same time, it makes me want to keep doing this because, you know, at the end of the day, your beliefs are not going to make me judge you as a character unless you try to infringe and impose your beliefs on me, or you try to shut down me for having my beliefs that are different than you. That's where the problem is, and that's where we are as a country right now. And that's why I feel like it's important for people like you and I to stand up and to speak out and don't be bullied into silence. Thank you so much again for watching. I will see you later. Have a really good weekend.